In this video, we're going to look at deploying Windows 7 by using WDS. So we'll look at designing the Windows Deployment Service environment, installing and configuring the server role, adding boot and install images to the WDS server, provisioning drivers, and then deploying a desktop operating system using Windows Deployment Services. Okay, so let's go into our server manager. And from here we'll click on roles. And we're going to add roles. And we're going to select Windows Deployment Service. From here we're next through the wizard. Now we're going to choose both the deployment server, which gives us the full functionality of WDS, and we're also going to select transport server, which gives us a subset of the functionality of WDS. It's basically just the core networking parts. So we're going to next and then install. And WDS is installed on this box. Okay, with that done, we'll close down our server manager and let's take a look at WDS. So if we go start administrative tools, we go to Windows Deployment Service, we'll expand servers, and we're going to configure LUN DC1. Okay, so we see at the moment it's not configured, we're going to choose to configure our server. So from here we're going to next through the wizard. We're going to install this on /remote install. And because DHCP is running on the server, we're going to add two tick boxes for 67 and port 60. We're going to respond to all client computers, known and unknown, but require administrative approval for the unknown computers. Basically, they end up in pending devices and we have to allow them. Okay, so Windows Deployment Services is configured. And when it's complete, we're going to choose not to add images now and finish the wizard. Okay, if I expand WDS, you can see we've got a number of folders: install, boot, pending devices, multicast transmission, and drivers. If I go on to boot images, let's add a boot image. And we'll choose our file location. And we're going to select our DVD, and we're going to select boot.wim. And it's just a 32-bit PE setup. Okay, and that's now successfully done. If we go in, let's add an install image. So we're going to create an image group and we're going to call this marketing. And the file locations, back into our DVD, we're going to select install.wim. It's going to be for Windows 7 Enterprise. Now Windows 7 Enterprise is effectively the same as Windows 7 Ultimate. It's the only difference is the licensing. With Windows 7 Enterprise, you go through an enterprise licensing server. Through Ultimate, you've got individual licenses as well as Macs. So we'll just add the Windows 7 Enterprise image. And with that done, we'll finish the wizard. And we'll go ahead and we will add some drivers. So we're going to add a driver package. And we're going to select all driver packages from a folder. And I'm going to browse to my E drive, my lab files, drivers, and VX6000, which is Microsoft LifeCam video camera. Okay, so we will select our drivers. and we'll add the driver package. And from here we're going to create a new driver group, and we're going to call this driver group VX6000 LifeCam. Okay, so we've now got drivers. If we go in and modify the LifeCam properties, we're going to add a filter, and we're going to do it to a laptop chassis type. Okay, so we've got our boot images, we've got our install images, we've got our drivers. So I'm now going to go into LunCL3 and we're going to boot this up. It's going to do a Pixie boot and it's going to download this image. So we can see the Pixie is initialized. It's going to connect up to the DHCP server. And we're going to press F12 for a network boot. Okay, so now we've got our information. We need to go back into our server to approve this unknown computer. So on pending devices, we can see that we've got our computer with a request ID. We're going to approve this and we're going to give it a name. I'm going to call this machine LUN Client 3. Okay, we can see that it's successfully approved. If we go back into our new client, we can see that it's now loading files. From here, we can select our locale. We're going to connect up to our DC, so we're right now our Contoso administrator credentials. We select our disk partition. And it will begin pulling the files down from the server. And our Windows 7 machine will begin installing.